nice paradox because the healthcare technology seems rather strict and technological, of course, and cold. And on the other hand, the narrative is perhaps more warm, human-like. I'd like to work in this paradox and try to bring them together. And I think, they both have their value, and it is good, therefore, to try to bring them together, because on the one hand, technology can help us to learn more about people and their behaviors and their health situation, whereas the narratives are in particular very important in establishing good contact with people or motivating them to behave in a more healthy way. One of the projects that we do is that we analyze email conversations. So as a psychologist, I also work on mental health. And in this project, we work together with an institute for addiction treatment. And they have had an online treatment for quite some time. So they have collected thousands of email conversations between therapists and clients who suffer from an addiction disorder. And there we are interested mainly in the question, does the therapy really fit the person? Will a person be motivated to finish the therapy? And because it is one of the difficult things in online therapy that people start but then also quickly stop after a number of sessions. So we want to predict the adherence to the therapy, as well as for some persons the therapy is successful and for others it isn't. And there we also want to know for which people is the therapy successful or not. We do that by analyzing the emails, and there we use all kind of different tools. And until now, we mainly focus more on psychological tools like linguistic inquiry and word count, or the therapeutic cycle model, which is really, both are really quite theoretically informed. But we are also looking for ways to do some more unsupervised machine learning and to see, can we predict from the emails the people who will adhere and who will have success in the therapy. I think the main thing is community building. Getting people from Clarin together with more domain researchers like psychologists or other humanities and social scientists. Because I think there are quite a lot of different things that you need to tackle, at least from my point of view as a psychologist, when working also with Clarin. And that comes, for example, to things like what are the data resources or the corpora that you are working with, and especially the kind of corpora that I work with in healthcare are also really sensitive data and private. So there we really need to solve questions like how can you make these kind of data available to other researchers, but also things like when it comes to web tools, can we use the web tools also for these kind of private data, because once you throw them in a web tool, you don't know really what happens with them and where they will also be stored. So that is also an important thing, I think. And that's perhaps more on the infrastructural level. And then there are, of course, all the questions about interdisciplinary work, words like annotation. I really first had to learn that as a psychologist, what is meant with annotation, because in psychology, when we do more like content analysis, we say, we code data, and there are some similarities and differences between the kind of concepts, of course, but I think that is also important to see how can we bring that closer together. And also the quite technological approach that is often taken, and how can that inform also the psychological research questions. Psychologists often want to work from particular theories that they have and make kind of predictions and interpretations about the data. And I think that is also important, and therefore you also need some community building in bringing these disciplines together in how are we going to contribute also to the psychological research questions, these kind of data and tools.